We started stuff with Beer Warmth about 3 years ago. And we developed a relationship with them, which means they now have about 5 hours more film on black people than they did in the first place, before we got involved, yeah? And also, we've had thousands of people get all together, go to Beer Warmth, who had never been there before, we're not friends of black men doing things. And that short interview there, which took a day, half a day to film actually, went out to millions of people who, of course, would never have seen that stuff unless it was for me doing that kind of stuff in the first place. So that is a scary thing. That's the power of black men, the sort of things we can do when we do get together, do organize, and just, you know, get on with it, basically. Because that was a self-planned, self-organized thing. Nobody gave us enough funding, we just go and do it for ourselves. So that's what we're trying to do. We do it because it needs to be done. Secondly, now let's move on to some other people, because Ulrich Cross, I got a short interview with him. Connie Mars, another amazing woman from Jamaica, who is responsible for the awareness we now have on Mary Seacole to a great extent, but she also helped to preserve a lot of the photographs you saw on this point you can see on the slideshow. So you'll see Ulrich Cross, you'll see Connie Mark, you're also going to see a guy called Billy Strachan, who's another amazing man, and you'll see a woman called Lillian Bader, who is a black woman born here in 1911. So as far as 1911, you have black people being born here, growing up and then going up to fight. So you'll see all those people talking, pay attention to what they say, because when we come back to later on, I'll be testing you.
You were
half-blind.
Very briefly, what is a
half-blind? Well, we went in ahead of the bombers and dropped flares so that the bombers could bomb our flares. They can't find the forces established, but it was fairly early in the war at any rate that a large percentage of bomber command bombs were not going on the targets. And so a bombardment force was established to drop markers in what we led with the red flags.
When you came to Britain to join in the war effort, you must have met for the first time lots of different people from different Caribbean islands. How was that?
Well, the communications were so bad at that time. I had never been to Jamaica until I came here. So it's how I come here to Jamaica.
So is it exciting? I mean,
it was very exciting, very interesting.
Oh, yes, indeed. Couldn't have met Mr. Mackin there, but Strachan, you were involved in the war effort. What were some of the reasons why you were involved?
Well, at a very sad moment ago, please assume my voice.
Now, this contribution has been largely ignored by historians and movie makers, and currently obviously been trying to set this record straight with your exhibition. Tell us about the exhibition.
Yes, I had a be my body over here. Got a bad idea that meant that I was an artist. We didn't know who was doing the black women in the army. I have to say that there were the black women serving here during the war with the bombs. I mean, everybody was in shock, so I said, oh well. So I put my thinking cap on. And I applied for the Great Northern Arts in London, and they gave me a grant. And I was able to get some photographs of the Imperial Museum from someone that I had of myself. And I've been going to the West Indies, I chaperone beauty queens, of course. Every time I go to Grenada or to Trinidad or anywhere, I said, meet ex-service women. I say to them, have you opened photographs to them on my exhibition? And I've been collecting them like that.
So what's been the reaction to your exhibition?
Shock. I still get, we didn't know there were black women in the army. Some people are discolored. I didn't know the idea of sort of thing, but I'm very glad that I stood my ground and I've done it. And if I die tomorrow, I've achieved what I wanted to have done, to let people know that there were black women in the army, there were black women during the war here in the United Kingdom, and we have done our bit for all of our country.
You actually don't know it, but you're surprised by what you found in the project.
Yeah, I was really surprised because it was the tour end of last year, this year. We actually knew that any black people in the war at all. It was just, you see the films and it's just a white man being really proud of his country. Mm. And it really shocked me.
So, I mean, let's come to you. I mean, those sort of films you was mentioned earlier, it's Paxton with American GIs. And have you seen the film with that?
No, not really. I was very surprised because when we find out at school about these things, you only find certain pages with black people on, and you didn't think that blacks did help through the war. It surprised me awful lot when I'm on my friends.
Uh-huh. How do you feel about the fact that some black people left out of the war and English lessons are not taught there?
Well, they made such a major contribution. Why are they being forgotten?
That's a question I'd press on to you. Where do you think they're?
Well, the only reason I could think of was because we were either ashamed that we had to ask for help, or were prejudiced.
Well, for everyone who was so confused or unsure about what we're dealing with, here's my film that I'd like to see in the 50th anniversary celebration.
And now I'm going to ask Flying Officer Bowling Cross to speak for opinions in the film.
Well, it's a tough and over to start. There are so many of us doing so many different things. In the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, in SC Rescue and Marines, in the RENs, the ATS, the WAC, and the Nursing Services. If I could navigate you on a magic carpet, we find West Indians at their stations all over the country, and in lots of other places which I'm not allowed to mention.
That was a very short piece of video, but there were so many famous people there, it wasn't funny.